growing up, like, never thought much about what was in front of us. We just ate it. I don't remember thinking about organic. I never even knew it was an option. I never thought about food the way I do now.
Yeah, I wanted to find something to get me out of the office and get my hands dirty and actually, like, create something.
And this just fell into my lap because we have the space to do it.
Now I don't have any yard, but I have food.
This is referred to as baby kale. It's so tender. Yeah, it's just a hobby for me. So it's really given me an appreciation for commercial farming. Man, so much of it's out of your control. See that little guy putting all those holes in there? My nemesis. You could get insects. The weather can be bad. There could be too much rain, not enough rain. Too much fog, not enough fog. Even though we're not in San Francisco, there's San Francisco fog right above us. Baby, open wide, you got the whole picture of what's in a box on our little farm is all local product. I started using oyster shell flour that's from Tamalpais Bay. For our strawberries, we started adding just real finely ground up kelp that's from Bolinas, and added fertilizer from Ecoscraps. They make for tomatoes to all of our tomato plants here. And it has a 5-4-6 composition, but they add calcium to prevent blossom end rot, which we had a lot of last year. So it's gonna be really interesting to see how that helps fight off disease this year. As you can see, we're just getting going, but these look really healthy and so far so good. These food scraps that people are throwing away at restaurants are just being turned into something really magical and are helping to grow our food. Our blueberries last year were so amazing, and these are really good too. My daughter just loves them. She helped me pick those this morning. She just eats and picks.
Thank you. Thank you. Let's see.
Mm. Mine was really good.
I did harvest a couple days ago, so they're not many. Kind of more like to give to the family than to a restaurant, but they're tasty. It's like a jungle through here. Once I started exploring, hey, if I grow food, what do I do with it? And I didn't realize that every person I told that I was growing food who's in the restaurant business said, like, oh, I'll buy whatever you have. So we have 8 pounds of kale, and then just Lexi picked some chives and tarragon for them too. And then I haven't weighed the tomatoes yet. So that's today's harvest. My friend owns the Parkside and I surf with him. He was hounding me all last summer. How's it going up there? How the veggies? He was right because I feel part of that community. I'm down there surfing a bunch, and it just made a lot more sense for me to drive our produce down there. Best feeling I have is bringing the food into a restaurant and thinking, this is gonna feed people tonight and tomorrow and the next day, and seeing the chef just say, like, oh, this looks amazing, thank you. You know, that's the gratification. As far as your value to the community and to people that you know and people you don't know, it's substantial. But so you're part of the circle. You really are. I didn't know that was gonna happen, but that's why I wanna continue doing it, is because it's important.